Kentucky Fried Children
by Simon Hood.
On a farm in West Kentucky lived a smart and rather plucky
gigantic speckled farmyard hen who measured in at 6'10".
This was no ordinary bird. Her intellect was quite absurd. She read 1,000 books a day, and locals there would often say,
"This hen is ludicrously smart. Her IQ score is off the chart. It was so clearly plain to see,
and nobody would disagree.
She had, without a single doubt, phenomenal amounts of clout.
To look at her, you'd think that she was happy as a bird could be, but deep inside a furry burned, ever since the time she learned.
Her carefree days were all but done, and soon she'd end up in a bun, alongside mayonnaise-y gunk and other slimy, greasy junk.
Then processed, paper-wrapped and sold, on discount to a 10-year-old.
She thought, this really cannot be the way that things shall end for me. It drives me absolutely wild to think that I'd end up in a child.
And selling me for 50 cents, quite frankly, makes me take offense. I will devise a cunning plan to dodge that wretched frying pan and seek revenge on little chops that scoff at fast food chicken shops.
Those nasty girls and boys that munch upon my tender meat for lunch. She mulled it over night and day, then at last she cried,
"Hooray!
Now that I've thought this through, I know exactly what to do. I'll start a brand new chicken shop, but every bit of meat I'll swap." She paused a moment, then she smiled for tender juicy bits of child.
"I think I'll wait," she said. "The little blighters are in bed. Then snatch the greasy stinky tots and fry them in my cooking pots. I must, of course, remove the hair.
Apply my secret crispy layer.
And serve them in a bucket too.
My ever faithful farmyard crew. Then when she cried, they are the meal. They'll understand just how we feel."
The end.